Hi all, in this video, let's look into HTML tags, which will improve the SEO, search engine optimization. Firstly, why we need this search engine optimization is, the benefits of this search engine optimization is, it will help us to discover our website and gives more visibility to our web pages as well. So also it will boost our web traffic. So the people, number of people who are coming to our website, it will try to increase the site traffic as well. So that is about the search engine optimization benefits. So we need to improve the search engine optimizations for the better traffic. So let's discuss some of the HTML tags which help us to improve this SEO. So coming to the first tag, we will be discussing about the title tag. So title tag is like a clickable header. So where we need to use the primary keyword or secondary keyword or the brand name. So let me show you. So here, this would be the title tag. Whatever you give there, SEO tries to pick this as a title tag. So it consists of 50 to 60 characters. If you give more than 60 characters, the rest of the characters would be cut off. So this is about the title tag, and we need to give this with an attractive keywords. Okay, whatever you type here, so you need to keep that in mind, and you need to give this as attractive keywords so that the users are ready to click our headline. So this is like a first clickable headline. So this is what we click to navigate to our web pages. So the important tag is like title tag. Try to provide this with the primary and the secondary keywords, as users will be trying to search like this. So we need to try to provide the similar keywords at this primary and the secondary keywords as a title. So the second tag is like meta tag, meta description tag. So this is how we need to do, like meta name is a description, and now you need to provide some content. So what exactly this website is going to give us. So where you can see, where you can find this. This is what the meta tag description is defined. So this is how it will be there. So max, it will be consisting of 150 to 160 characters. So beyond that, if you have given, so the Google will cut off the characters and it will just give like dots like this. So this is about the meta description tag. It will help us a lot in the search engine optimization. So we need to give appropriate keywords where exactly what people are searching and what they need exactly from our website. We need to give more relevant information about our website. So if we ignore this, if you ignore this meta tag description tag, then Google will try to give a appropriate relevant description for our web page itself. So Google helps us in that way as well. So coming to the third part is like HTML pages. So HTML pages means like we'll be having HTML tags like this. So these HTML tags, header tags, basically, these header tags will help us to structure the page both for the readers and for the search engines as well. So for example, we have an article, okay? We know no one will read that article from top to bottom. They will try to scroll down the article, and if they find something interesting, they will stop at that point. So it means we need to use the header tags in such a way that we need to use this appropriate to the sections, so that we need to make the importance of the articles. We need to divide the article in terms of sections so that user will be stopping at one section and he will try to read and he will be concentrating on that particular section. So this is about the header tag. These header tags helps us the search engine optimization to preserve the heading tags, and it will tell what exactly the page or the content that section is doing. Okay, so that the search engine will quarrel and it will try to pick the appropriate keywords and it will show this section as well. So in this way, the search engine optimization helps us. So all the sections should be consistent. It means if you're starting with H2 or HT tag, then try to continue these tags for all the sections. The header tags should be consistent for the sections. We need to treat this header tags as additional opportunity to rank our web page. So this is in short about the header tags. In sense, these are important for our SEO. Try to maintain them. For each section, you need to maintain these header tags, where the search engine optimization tries to quarrel this, and it will pick the keywords, appropriate keywords as a respective search query, and it will pick the exact search results. So coming to the fourth one is like image alt text. So we are talking about the fourth point, like image alt text. So usually this alt keyword we use for the web accessibility purpose. Now SEO goal here by using this alt keyword is to provide the image indexing. So it will provide the image indexing so that even if the image is not available, even if the image is broken, with the help of this image indexing, it will try to pick the appropriate content for the SEO. So that's the reason you need to give the alt text attribute for sure. So even if the image was broken, and this text will help the SEO. Just give the description what the image is there. So what is this image? You need to give that description so that it will pick appropriate search result query. So coming to the schema markup. So I'm talking about the fifth point, that is schema markup. So where you can define the properties like this. If you define the properties like this, like you're specifying more properties, it means you are giving more information. It uses to enhance the result set. So for example, so if you see normal search result page is like this. So there is no much interesting part here. So if you give something like interesting, like a nutrition restaurant like this, so it has provided us something like this, the stars, rating and votes like this. So this is like a schema markup. This gives an additional information and attractive than the normal search results. So how to use them is like we have a schema.org here. So if you go to here, this website, you can search for like recipes, books, like anything. So here you can give the appropriate, like if you want to provide some offers, okay, use these properties. So like that, if you use these properties, offers, like ratings, and it will give more snippet. It will give more understandable, like a better search result. So it has more chances for the users to click this website. Also based upon this rating, SEO will try to fetch our website at the top. So try to use this schema markup to provide more additional attractive information code templates to appear in the first search engine result page. So this is about schema markup. So about HTML5 segment tags. So let me discuss about the sixth point, that is about HTML5 semantic tags. I'm sorry, this is about semantic tags. In the earlier stages before HTML5, we would be using div tags and paragraph span tags throughout the applications. There won't be any division between these things. But after HTML5, if you use a footer tag like this, or you can use an header tag, footer tag, many tags you can use like this, which will help SEO a lot. It will try to pick that based upon the importance. It will pick this SEO. SEO will work in such a way that if you have any header tag, if you use header tag instead div, if you use div, it can't understand what that exactly that div is going to do. But if you give an header tag like this, it will give more importance to this header tag, and it will try to fetch the content from this header tag for SEO optimization. So it's better to use HTML5 semantic tags that will help SEO more. So coming to the seventh point, that is robots tag. So if you give a tag like this and you provide a content like a no index or something, so this will not improve our SEO. It will tell to the search engine optimization whether to index this page or not, whether to follow this page or not. If you have a sensitive information in your application, you're thinking that search engine optimization should not index my page, it should not follow my page, then this would be a better option. Use this and keep the content like no index, no follow. You can give, there are properties like this, no index, no follow. Then Google can understand properties with a smaller case. You can give multiple things like this, so it can understand, and it will, search engine optimization will not index our pages. So this is this attribute we need to use in order to make a set of rules for the search engine optimizations, whether to index our page or not, whether to follow our page or not. So in this way, we can use this tag from search engine optimization. And finally, the last attribute is about canonical tag. So this is about this canonical tag. So in example, for example, in a web page, you might be having few pages with the identical content. So this canonical tag will give high priority. It will tell to the search engine optimization to pick this page first, give priority to this page than the other page. Because in a web page, if you have multiple, in a web page, you might have identical content in one or the other pages. So now this canonical tag will give the priority to one page so that SEO will not be confused. So if two pages will have identical content, then SEO will get confused to which page it needs to give high indexing. So in that case, this canonical tag will help us and it will give priority to that particular page so that SEO can understand to give high priority to that page and it will quarrel that page result set. So this is about this canonical tag. So finally, let me explain you about one software like if you want to check with this software, so we have a website auditor. In download this. This is free of cost. If you download this SEO audit, and if you open this, and I have given the linkedin.com, so it will provide us this website auditor will provide us the search results like this. So now you can understand what you can improve in terms of SEO. Okay, hope this will help you. In terms of, you can understand if you click something, it will give the appropriate things what to do for your application. It will give hints to improve the search engine optimization as well. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. This is all about the HTML tags to improve the